केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वन्दे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः। यो ब्रह्माण विधाति पूर्वं येदागश्च प्रहिणोति तस्मै तदुमहदेवमात्मबुद्धिप्रकाशं मुक्षु वै शरणं प्रपद्ये। शान्तिश्शान्तिश्शान्तिः। श्रीचिद्घनगणेश नमो मह्यं सुखनित्यं सुप्रकाशं व्यापकं नामरूपाधिष्ठानं बुद्ध्यभूत्यं बुद्ध्यदृक्यत्वनिर्मापारं सर्ववेदान्तवेद्यं प्रत्यक्परं तदेवाहन्नमत्त्वं निश्चितामतिः। पंचकोश विवेक टॉपिक कंटिन्यूज एंड एलोबोरेट्स द साधु हैज गिवन ब्रॉड गाइडलाइंस एंड सम डिटेल्स आल्सो स्वामी जी एलोबोरेट्स इन द टिप्पणा। सो स्थूल देह विवेचनम हाउ डू यू नो दैट यू आर नॉट स्थूल देह यथा घटस्य उत्पत्ति विनाशयोः प्राग् ऊर्ध्वं च विद्यमानत्वाद् एकत्वाच्च आकाशः घटाद विभिन्न अव्यभिचारी च तथा। सो यूजिंग द एग्जांपल ऑफ घटा एनी जड़ वस्तु यू लुक एट इट बिफोर द उत्पत्ति एंड विनाश बिफोर द उत्पत्ति ऑफ विनाश सॉरी उत्पत्ति ऑफ घटा एंड आफ्टर द विनाश ऑफ द घटा। सो घटस्य उत्पत्ते हे प्राक एंड घटस्य विनाशस्य ऊर्ध्वम विनाशात ऊर्ध्वम। So before the utpatti of ghata and after the vinash of ghata, what is there? Akasha is there. Ghata ceases to be there. But akasha, ghata akasha continues to be there. It was there before the ghata came in and during the ghata also akasha was there. After the ghata vinasha also akasha is there. So akasha is vyapaka. In comparison, nityascha. However, ghata is avyapaka and anitya. So you look at anvaya vyatireka. And ekatvaccha. Akasha is one, continues as one. Ghatas are many. You see difference between ghatas. Ghatas are varying. The ghata during the formation also, before the painting, after the painting, it looks different. So it's varying. Some change is there, but that change isn't there in the akasha. So ghatat vibhinnaha. Ghata, it is different. Akasha is different from ghata and avyabhichari does not change when the ghata changes or goes through all shadvikaras. In comparison, in the exemplified, we have to look at the shadvikaras. Stula deha undergoes all the vikaras. So tatha stula dehasya जनन मरणयोः प्राग् ऊर्ध्वं च विद्यमानत्वात् एकत्वाच्च आत्मा स्थूल देहात् भिन्नः अव्यभिचारी च। सो एक्सटेंड इट टू द आत्मा सतः अभावो न विद्यते एंड देन असतः भावः न विद्यते। असत हियर इज डिफरेंट फ्रॉम सत नॉट कंप्लीटली नॉन एग्जिस्टेंट सो मिथ्या दैट इज द स्टेटस ऑफ घटा and similarly of stula deha also. Ghata eva stula dehaha janana maranayoh pragurdhvancha avartamanatvat anekatvatcha atmanah bhinna vyavicharicha. So you see variety of ghatas. Similarly, you see varieties of stula dehas and does not exist before birth in that form. In that nama rupa, it does not exist. Therefore, it is only nama rupa. Nama matra really. बट नाम रूप यद अधिक देश कालवर्ती तद अव्यभिचारी इत्युच्यते। व्हाट इज अव्यभिचारी हियर व्यभिचारः न विद्यते यस्य दैट इज अव्यभिचारी नंज बहुरी बट व्हाट डज इट मीन द that which is adhika desha adhika desha kala varti, so that which is present in adhika desha and adhika kala, that is avyabhichari. So atma is avyabhichari while deha is stula, deha is vyabhichari. Sarva sharira varti atma eka eva. The aham bhava in any prani, any jiva is the same. There is no difference. You cannot show the differentiation in satta. If you say that the satta of the other jiva is different, atma is different than my satta. So, if it is different, then what it amounts to mean is that there is no satta in between. If there are five jivatma, five pranis, let's say, jivas and pranis put together, if you say that there are five atmas, then what will it amount to mean is that sad atma are five, meaning satta is differentiated into five, which means that between these five sattas, there is asat, there is no satta. If that were so, then we would not cognize the akasha. We would not know that there is space in between. Do we know that there is space between me and someone else? Between two others? So between all of us, whatever space exists, that does exist, there is anuruti of satta. So you cannot segment the atma separately. You cannot say that there is vyabhichara in one atma and the other atma, because satta vyabhichara is not possible. There cannot be asat in between. There is no anuruti. We don't say that there is no space in between you and me. We don't say that. Why? Between me and the ghata also, we don't say that there is no space. We say there is space. That astitva bhava of akasha also is due to the satta anuvritti. That satta is atma satta. So atma cannot be many, dual. There has to be non-dual, eka eva atma. Sarva sharira varti. Whether you cognize in each and every sharira, you understand that it being in each and every sharira, it is okay, but it is not segmented. Between two shariras also, there is atma. Because we may not know the akasha, but akasha is still there. We may not see that akasha has the underlying satta, which is atma, atma satta. Similarly, with the other aspects also, we use the in the lakshana, satyam jnanam anantam brahma, we use whatever is more convenient to understand. We take that aspect of atma and analyze. Whether it is consciousness in one case or satta in one case, it doesn't matter, as long as you can see the ekatva of atma. Tasmad akashavad atma vyapakaha. This atma is vyapaka like akasha. You can understand the space is everywhere, which cannot be segmented. Similarly, akasha is more subtle than atma is more subtle than akasha. Therefore, akasha cannot be vyapaka if atma were to be avyapaka. So atma is definitely vyapaka then in comparison to akasha also. Ataha sarvadesha varti bhavati atma. Therefore, atma is sarvadeshavarti, present everywhere. Dehanam utpatti maranayoho pragurdvancha atma asti. And before utpatti and marana also atma is there. Where do you see the satta of atma? Before the ghatotpatti and ghata nasha urdhvam. Before the ghatotpatti and after the ghata nasha, the satta is seen in the mrit or the pieces of the ghata. Therefore, satta is there. It pervades the ghata also, the way it had pervaded the clay also before the ghatotpatti and after ghatanasha. You can see the satta in the shards, the pieces of the ghata, of a broken pot. Therefore, tasmad atma kalatraya avadya sarvakalavarti cha bhavati. This atmasatta is present through and through, before, during and after the ghatakala. Ghatasatta kala, you can say. Ghatasatta is the satta of the mrit. Evam sarvadesha kalavartitvad atma avyabhichari. Since atma is there in all deshas in and all kalas, therefore atma is avyabhichari. Yadhi vastu svalpadeshe svalpakale cha vartate tad vyabhichari. So vyabhichari, you see the change. What is the change? It does not remain in the same nama rupa. So svalpadeshe svalpakale cha yad vartate, whatever vastu is therein which covers a little space and is present in a little time duration, that is vyabhichari. Ghata iva deha api parichinna svalpadeshe vartate. And if you compare the ghata and deha, there is no difference in the vyabhicharitvam. Utpatti nashavancha deha sarvakalavarti na bhavati kintu svalpakaleva vartate. Because the ghata has utpatti nasha, it is not in all deshas and all kalas. You can see actually paricheda, only two parichedas are mentioned here. They will cover the others also. In fact, if you look at one, it will cover the other aspects also. There is desha parichinnatvam, kala parichinnatvam and vastu parichinnatvam. Ghata cannot be anything else. Why anything else? It cannot be any other ghata also. That is vastu paricheda. Then we have seen that the ghata is not there before and after its vinasha, before creation and after vinasha. Therefore, ghata is limited in time. If the ghata is at one place, it cannot be at the other place. So there is kala parichheda and desha parichheda also. Similarly, deha also, extended to deha, ghata iva deha api parichinna svalpa deshe vartate. Utpatti nashavancha deha sarvakala varti na bhavati kintu svalpa kale vartate. So there is desha paricheda and kala paricheda. Ataha svalpa desha kala vartitvat stula deha vyavichari. Atma is avyavichari. Evam dehatmanoho vyavicharitva avyavicharitva rupa vilakshana dharmatvad eva tayov parasparam bhedaha sidhyati. So you can see that I, Atma, am avyabhichari, whereas Deha is vyabhichari. In childhood, there was a different Deha, but I know that this is what I had Nama Rupa of. You know, my parents called me with a different name maybe. You know, childhood names are different after growing up. People don't like their childhood names. They say, no, I don't like this name. Don't call me this. So, nama has changed. Rupa has definitely changed. But I have anuritti. I continue to be the same Atma. Because there is pratyavijna. I know that I existed in this name and form. It was not no one else. It wasn't anyone else who was called with this name and Rupa. It was me. I claim it. But then I have continued to be there even when the deha has changed, the childhood deha is different. So the kala has changed. Desha also. Desha is different. Deha has moved. Some part of the deha has dropped off. Other parts have continued. So many factors can be seen to see difference between deha and me. So parasparam bheda siddhyati. Because of what? Vyabhicharitva, avyabhicharitva, if you analyze that. Deha is vyabhichari, I am avyabhichari. This kind of vilakshana dharma, if you look at dharmas, they are not really attributes, but then because they are attributes of the deha, the avyabhichara is also seen as attribute. It's not an attribute really. To counter, we need some word. Counter the vyabhichara. Tasmat na aham stula dehaha. I am not the stula deha. Na api madiha aso dehaha. Okay, I am not the stula deha. Can this stula deha be mine? Can there be sambandha shashti? Mama dehaha. I do say mama dehaha. At least that much you allow me. Na api madiha aso dehaha. Why? Kintu dehaha panchabhuta karyatvad bhautikaha. So madiha means my own. When you generally when the parents say, you know, my own child, the abhimana is very different than madiya deha. Here madiya deha na, meaning it has not come from me. Not really come from me. It's a bhranti. It's a kalpana that I own it. I didn't create the deha. Really, if you look at it, I didn't create the deha at all. Parents can claim that the child's deha is mine. But really, if you look at, they cannot claim their own deha. I cannot claim my deha as mine. Then, in fact, my deha which produces my child, can it be claimed really as mine? So, something to think over. Kintu deha pancha bhuta karyatvad bhautikaha. Bhuta karya, pancha maha bhuta karya. Mama stula deha vyatiriktatvadeva cha tad ashrita namarupa jatyashrama karmadayaha dharmaha na mam sprashanti. So I am not the deha. The deha is also not really mine. I didn't create it. I don't really own it. I cannot stake claim over it. It has been entrusted to me. I have been given this body as a housing. I do say my house, but then if you find, let's say, oil or gold in US oil, maybe, or gold under your house, you know, you want to make some basement parking area or something, whatever, sort of thing, something, or you want to create a sump or something and you're digging, you found gold. Will the government let you keep that? It's not yours. It belongs to the government. The rule of the land is that the land really, you, although you buy the land, what you buy is you buy rights to build and reside there. The land belongs to the government, to the country. This deha also is entrusted to you, does not really belong to you in that sense. So ahankara and mamatva, that mamakara, ahankara, mamakara has to go with this stula deha. So it is not only with ahankara that I am not the deha. So pancha kosha viveka, although has a step of mama deha, which helps me understand it is not raho shira vasashti. Rahu and shira are same, but here my deha and me are different. So there we use that mama deha as a step of viveka to land on I being different from the deha. But here, Swamiji does something more. He says that mamatva also you have to drop. Otherwise, what will happen? Finally, you will say, I am pratyagatma with these five koshas. No, I am the pratyagatma without the koshas. Atma, first atma bhava has to be taken away. Ahankara goes away. Then atma, these koshas, become koshas, they do not remain as atma. But even after that, this mamakara also should have be dropped. If I don't drop the mamakara with my deha, it is not possible, it is not going to be easy to drop mamakara with other dehas. So the bondage will continue. Therefore, in the panchakosha viveka itself, Swamiji does a little more. He says, deha panchabhuta karyatvat bhautikaha mama stula deha vyatiriktatvatcha tadashrita namarupa jatyashrama karma deha dharmaha na maam sprishanti. If the house is damaged, I feel hurt because there is mamakara in the, with the graha. Similarly, with the deha, there is mamakara. That is why there is dukkha when you know there is disease or something wrong with the deha, there is mamakara, and therefore that mamakara causes dukkha. That is also binding. So later step, but still a step to be taken forward. Na pite dharmaha mat sambandina. They are not related to me. Iti stula sharira viveka. This is the stula deha viveka. Further, how do you do sukshma deha viveka? Sukshma deha vivechanam. Shushupti murcha maranam pralaya jnanam iti panchasu avasthasu linga deha swakarane ajnane liyate. This sukshma deha resolves. Linga deha is sukshma deha is also called as linga deha. Why? Because it is a linga. It is an indicator to land on atma. How so? Because it mimics. It mimics. You see the atma. It is in the atma mimics as though. Whenever there is an emoting mind, I have more association there, and then it drags me. I feel that I am emotional. I have this kind of an emotion. Therefore, I am emotional. That I have versus I am, there is a confusion. But then, if you inquire into it, then the sukshma deha becomes an indicator to point the atma. Going inward, subtler, using Shaka Chandra Nyaya, it becomes a linga, the closest. Because Anandamaya Kosha, when you land on Anandamaya Kosha, it's very difficult to analyze the kosha itself. So it cannot help in the indication of atma. So panchasu avasthasu linga deha swakarane ajnane liyate. The karana sharira is karana for sharira dvaya, stula sharira as well as linga sharira. This linga sharira resolves in its own karana ajnana when in five avasthas, which are those? Shushupti, murcha, maranam, pralaya and pralaya jnanam iti. We'll see what this is anyway. Shushupti, we know shushupti. Murcha is coma. Maranam also we know pralaya. So nitya pralaya is shushupti and dirgha kalina shushupti is pralaya. We know these. And jnanam, we'll see. Jnanam is when, which counts as ajnana. Therefore, in ajnana, the linga deha will resolve. What remains is shuddha chaitanya. That is the jnana avastha. So, in these five cases, avasthas, linga deha, swakarane, ajnani, liyate, tasma, sukshma deha, vyabhichari, asatcha, asancha, asan. It's a pullinga, therefore, asat will become asan, and it's a sandhi, asancha. So tasmat sukshma deha vyabhichari. Sukshma deha is vyabhichari. Sometimes it is in a resolved state, sometimes in a manifest state, and then there are so many bhedas, so many emotions, so many personalities. A different association with the spouse, with the child, even between children, a slightly different association. You know, elder, younger, have to have a different association. With parents also, again, the father a different relation, with the mother a different relation, manifests in a subtle form. Different bhava. With the sister, brother, a different relation. With the boss, with the subordinates, definitely different relation. All that does not look different in the stula sharira. Stula sharira is the same, but in linga sharira, there is vyabhichara. How I connect with another. Raga dvesha driven also. Therefore, kama krodha hir bhir dhi sarvayam manayeva. So vyabhichari is the sukshma deha, linga deha is vyabhichari, atma tu sarvakaleshu api prakashamanatva avyabhichari. So in shushupti, murcha, marana pralaya and jnana avastha, linga deha resolves, but atma continues to be there. Be it in bija form, shushupti, murcha, marana, whenever. It is in bija form but still resolved, unmanifest. However, atma is ever manifest. Ever manifest is ever present. The manifestation is only when something else manifests, it will be a reflection. Reflection may come and go, but still Atma is ever present. Therefore, Atma sarva kaleshu api prakashamanutva, ever present, alupta druk, sarvada sakshi eva, sarvada drugeva natu drishyate, says Bhagavan Vidyaranacharya in Drik Drishya Viveka. Sarvada druk, kadapi na drishyate, never drishya, always adruk, alupta druk. Ataha sadrupascha. So trikala abaditvat sadrupa atma. Sadrupatvad atmanu lingadeha. And since atma is not agantuka, but lingadeha is agantuka, therefore atma is not lingadeha. Lingadeho api na atma sambandhi. Can there be mamaka, this mama lingadeha, mama sukshmashara, mama manaha, mama buddhi, mama pranaha, all these are ideas which are incorrect because there is no shashti sambandha also. Satu lingadehaha apanchikrita panchamahabhuta karyam. Just like earlier we saw stula panchamahabhuta karyam, similarly here sukshma panchamahabhuta karyam, meaning apanchikrita. Tasmat naham lingadeha, I am not lingadeha, I am not sukshma sharira, kartrutva bhoktrutva sukadukhadi lingadeha dharma api naham. Dharmas cannot be mine either. They cannot be my dharmas. I am not the dharmas. They are not my dharmas. Both ways you can see. Na pite dharma madhiya. So, I am not the dharmas of the sukshma sharira. And they are not my dharmas. They are sukshma sharira dharmas. So, there, if there is kama, krodha, hridhi, bhi, anything. All that is sukshma sharira dharma. Linga diya dharma. Not my dharmas. So, tarkikas take all these as Atma dharmas, they are not Atma dharmas. Neither are they me, nor are they mine. So mamakar is also to be dropped. Tesham sakshi aham tebhyo bhinnaha. Sadrishyatvat mithya, I am a sakshi, while they are all, I am drik sakshi, and they are drishya. It is sukshma deha vivechanam. This is how one differentiates from the sukshma deha. Karana deha, Viveka, how do you do that? Karana deha vivechanam, ajnanam eva karana deha. There is no other karana deha. Ajnana itself is karana deha. Causal body. Cause of what? Cause of two other shariras. Naham karana deha. I am not the karana deha ajnana. Basically, jnana rupatvat, ajnana bhinna, atma, aham. Saha api namadiyaha. I am not the ajnana. And I am, so saha api namadiyaha. It is not mine. I claim the ajnana, but it is not really mine. Karana sharira dharma karana sharira dharmau avarna vikshepau api na aham. What about the karana sharira avidya ajnana dharmas? Avarna and vikshepa. They are also not me. They are not mine again. Natau dharmau madhiyau. Tayoho sakshi aham tabhyam bhinnaha. Do you know that you have ajnana? Yes. So, sambandha, maybe. So, first you take the sambandha and refute ahankara. I am not ajnana. Why? Because I know the ajnana. Drishyatvat bhinnaha. Drishyatvat mithya also. What I cognize cannot be me. That is the reason Atma is never objectifiable. If you objectify the Atma, you have not objectified the real Atma. You have objectified an avatar of Atma. The more you try to go within and do vichara and know that I am meditating, as soon as you are alert of your meditation, and even during meditation, there are various mechanisms to come back to the thought, which is the object of meditation. Be shabda, rupa, whatever it is, or a thought, prana, whatever it is, you are meditating upon Ishvara, Ishtadevata, Guru, whatever. Omkara Shabda, anything with the open eyes or closed eyes. The idea is to come back to the thought. So, Dharana. Then there is Dhyana. But as soon as you are alert that I am meditating, you have spun off. You have objectified the meditator you. which cannot be you. You have ended up objectifying yourself. That is not the goal. That is far from the goal. So you are objectifying something, but then you don't objectify the objectifier subject. You cannot watch over yourself. As soon as you do that, it is like a schizophrenia. You know, another personality has come up. We mimic the real Atma. No, this is me, but that is the Manaha. Or it is the, in Shushupti, what you cognize, the Ananda that you cognize, the darkness that you cognize is not you. So Ajnana is not you. Why? Because of objectification. Sakshi, you are a Sakshi. So Ajnanasya Sakshyatvat. Aham Sakshi, Ajnanasya Sakshyatvat, Aham Sakshya Ajnana Bhinnaha. I am different from the Sakshya Jnana. I am different from the Ajnana. Tabhyam Bhinnaha, Tabhyam Avarna Vikshepabhyam Bhinnaha. I am different from the Avarna and Vikshepa also, because I know there is Avarna. If I know that I don't know something, then I have objectified that Ajnana, therefore that Ajnana is not me. No one can tell me that you have understood this when I have not understood. I may be Bhranta, that is a different story. But if I really don't understand something and someone says, no, you already understand this. No, I don't understand this. I know that I don't understand because Ajnana is objectifiable to me. You can't objectify my Ajnana. I can. I am different from that Ajnana. From that Ajnana Avarana, which is known to me, and then it projects something. No, I think this is the meaning. If you tell me something and I think something else is the meaning, there is a Vikshepa. And if it is not really so, then it is a Vikshepa known to me. It appears differently to me. Rajju, you say it is Rajju, I say it is Sarpa. Why? Vikshepa of Sarpa is clear to me. Although I may not know it as Vikshepa, it is still seen to me, I cognize it, therefore I am not the Vikshepa. And they are not my dharmas either. Iti Karana Sharira Vivechanam. This is how you differentiate yourself from the Karana Sharira, Atma Anatma Viveka, at the Sharira Traya level. Then Jagradavastha Viveka. Jagradavastha Viveka, waking state, how do you discriminate there? Avastha Nama Dasha, Bhoga Kala Vishesha Rupaha. So avasthas are the states. What kind of states are these? These are bhoga kala vishesha rupa. I am experiencer through and through. That is the reason I have taken janma. I was a karta wanting to have bhoga, and now taking this janma I have become a bhokta. This janma is really for pure bhoktrutvam. Every janma is for pure bhoktrutvam. The jagat srishti is for the jiva bhojana. Because the karma is ripe for fructification. If I could somehow not be a karta, then after the bhoga is exhausted, I would not take janma. This is the thinking of the Purvamimamsaka, but which is flawed. The only flaw there is that I cannot cease to be a karta. Bereft of jnana. So, bearing jnana, jnanotpatti, I cannot cease to be a karta. Therefore, bhoga never ends. And therefore, I keep on getting many janmas, claiming bhoktrutvam, being a bhokta, wanting to have bhoga. And that is how the jagat is configured for my bhoga. This is for each and every individual to think. Entire jagat is a sum total of whatever bhoga is due to the sum total of jivas. So, bhoga kala vishesha rupas are these avastas. I cannot do some bhoga in a particular janma. I have to wait for another janma, another kind of sharira, another kind of loka also, another set of circumstances for some set of bhogas to be fructified, to be experienced. Bhogyas to be experienced. So, for some bhoga to be had of bhogya vastu. Because of what reason? Because of my karma. I have earned it. So, in this janma also, sambhoga is not possible. I have to wait across some kala. Sambhoga, which I can have only as an old or a young person, I cannot have as a child or a young person. So the kala has to be waited out. So you have to wait out for that bhoga, but it will be given. Similarly, across avasthas also, something which I cannot experience. Let's say there is some bhoga due to me of flying, but not, I have not earned it in the form of a bird or something else. In the human life itself, I have to undergo that bhoga. So perhaps it is not possible for me to fly, and it is not as bad as just flying off the cliff. So some bhoga is due. Then in jagrat avastha, that bhoga cannot take place. I have to wait it out for a particular swapna, where such a bhoga will be granted to me because I have earned it, which may cause fear, which may bring elation, I do not know. But it is earned. So avastha nama dashaha bhoga kala vishesha rupa. Some particular differences are there in bhoga and kala also. Swapna shushupti avastha vilakshanatve sati indriya janya jnana tat samskara adhara bhuta kala vishesha jagrat avastha. So jagrat avastha lakshana is given. What is the definition? Swapna shushupti avastha vilakshanatve sati, while being different from swapna and shushupti avastha, being indriya janya, so indriya janya jnana tat samskara adhara bhuta, kala vishesha is jagrat avastha. So jagrat avastha is a kala vishesha, that kind of a particular time, that state in a particular time, which is different from this swapna and sushupti kala avastha. Avastha and kala vishesha also, and also what? Indriya janya jnana, where there is indriya janya jnana, all the five indriyas are in play. Therefore, the jnana generated by these three is generated through these five indriyas. That is continuing there, that is possible. And this indriya janya jnana will leave behind impressions. So, samskaras, vasanas are generated. Tat samskara adhara bhuta. Actually, the samskaras become the adhara for furthermore jagrat avastha bhogas to be wanted, whereby karma will follow, and also this swapna kala also it will facilitate by the taste, whether raga or dvesha, the taste for that particular anubhava being there in the form of samskara. Tasyam avasthayam chaturdasha triputi bhir jivaha vyavaharati. So this is a little tricky anyway. In that avastha, chaturdasha triputi bhir jivaha vyavaharati. There are various ways in which the jiva continues to be there in the triputi. Asyam avasthayam shad vishesha. There are six visheshas he wants to talk about in this jagrat avastha. Avastavataha jivasya sthanam chakshuhu. Where is this jagrat jiva? Jagrat jiva is said to be, jiva is in the chakshu. Especially in a upasana, it is taught that I, the atma, am in the right eye. So this is one upasana, which is then equated with the Hiranyagarbha, meaning Surya Antargata. Actually, Surya upasana, Surya Antargata, Hiranyagarbha, Ishvara Samashti, I am meditating upon. But then what kind of I am in the chakshu. So jivasya sthana is chakshu in jagrat avastha. Sakala sharira vartinaha api jivasya chakshusha mukhya sthanatva tadeva sthanam ityuktam. Although this jiva is through and through the sharira, anaka paryantebhya, still there is some specific location mentioned in the Shruti also. Therefore, this is the sthana in the right eye. Shaktihi kriya. So anyway, this is all too many details. We don't need to inquire into this when we are differentiating. So we'll quickly go to Shakti, Kriya. So it's Shakti is Kriya, Vani, Vaikari, Bhoga, Stula. So Stula Bhoga, he has Stula Bhoga, that Jiva. And his Vani is called as Vaikari, means it is completely manifest. It can be heard by the others, loud and clear. So that is Vaikari, Vani. Kriya Shakti Man Jeeva, that time. He has Kriya as a Shakti. Guna Sattvam, Sattva Guna. Sanya Vishwaha, he is called as Vishwa at the individual level. Jagardavastha Avimani is called as Vishwa. Iyam Jagardavastha Swapna Shushupti Avasthayor Vyabicharati Iti Asanmai. Why is it Asat though? Jagardavastha, is it Sat or Asat? That is the Viveka finally we have to land on. Shakti, Vani, Bhoga, this is all a little, you know, Bhoga may be Stula Bhoga, may be valid, but then others, Guna, Ityadi, they may not help us in Viveka. If they do help, please use. But if they are confusing, you know, if they prod more questions, oh, I want to know what this Chaturdasha Triputi, Bhihi, Jeevaha, Vyavarati, what are these? So please do not ask me, I do not know. Because I expect this question, because generally, you know, something that I skip over, that will come up as a question in some WhatsApp chat or something else. So please do not ask me. I do not know. And I do not want to know either. What are these in this avastha? What are this vyavahara through? What kind of 14 vyavaharas do I do? I am really not interested. If you are, I would ask, why are you interested? You already do that vyavahara. What are you going to know or do by knowing your vyavaharas? You will get some names. This is my vyavahara. This is my vyavahara. But it is vyavahara, it is mithya. So please do not focus on that. Land here. Iyam jagradavastha swapna shushupti avasthayor vyabhicharati iti asanmai. That is the tatparya. Asanmai avastha, jagradavastha. Why? Vyabhicharati iti. Vyabhicharatvat. Because of having vyabhichara. Vyabhicharavatvat. Where is the vyabhichara seen? Jagradavastha, all this that he has listed here, does not continue to be there in Swapna and Shushupti. In Swapna and Shushupti, Swapna Bhoga is Sukshma. Vani is not Vaikari. You do not talk, the other do not hear, unless you are a, you know, sleep talker, sleep walker. Others don't hear you speak in Swapna. What you are speaking is Sukshma. So it is not Vaikari. Obviously, the Bhoga, it is not the Stula Prapancha, which is, you know, Bhogya. What Bhoga you are having is not of the Stula Prapancha, it is of the Sukshma Prapancha. So there is Bheda, Vyabhichara is there. Tat Sakshibhutaha tu Atma Sarvasu Api Avasthasu Anuvartamanatvat Satya Swarupa. Anuvritti of Atma, me, Aham, continues to be there. I am the one who was Vishwa. I am the one who is Tejasana, the dreamer. Therefore, there is no Vyabhichara in me, but there is Vyabhichara in the Avastha. Tat Sakshibhutaha tu Atma Sarvasu Api Avasthasu Anuvartamanatvat Satya Swarupa Tasma Jagrat Avasthataha Ayam Vilakshana Jeevaha. Ayam Vilakshana, Ayam is third person, but I should say Aham, Jeevatma, Atma, Brahmatma, Jagrat Avasthataha Bhinna Asmi, Vilakshana Asmi. Iti Jagradavastha Viveka. So I am different from the Jagradavastha and I am different from the Jagradavastha Abhimani also. Jagradavastha Abhimani, Vishwa is me, but I am not limited to being Vishwa. I am also Tejasa, whereas the Vishwa is not Tejasa. Vishwa does not know Tejasa, Tejasa does not know Vishwa. Of course, after I wake up, the Vishwa can claim that I was Tejasa, but the claimer is not really Vishwa. He is not the waker. He is absent in the dream. He may indirectly know the dreamer, but not directly the way the Sakshi knows. So Sakshi, I, Atma, I know the Vishwa and I know that I played the role of the Vishwa. I played the role of the Tejasa. Therefore, I am not Vishwa. I am not Tejasa. Meaning, I am not limited to these. When I say I am not Vishwa, I am not Tejasa, you should see it as I am Vishwa also, Tejasa also, Pragya also. and not only limited to these three. I am in the form of everything and everyone. That is the real Nityatvam. I appear as everything, but I am not limited to any one of those, any subset of those. Even the complete set is not what is the complete description of me. I am Purna. Even if this entire universe is seen as me, still it will be incomplete, because it cannot ever be Purna. Had it been Purna, it wouldn't be expanding further. The universe is ever expanding scientifically. Even if you look at my manas, manifestation as Tejasa, this Tejasa is ever expanding. I don't know what I'll be in my dream tonight. I don't know. It can be same, it can be different. So something more is there. In the waking also, in this Janma, I know what is happening today, right now. What is the role I am playing. But I don't know tomorrow what I have to do. So across Desha and Kala, I don't know how the Jagratavastha will change. How the Vishwa, Jagratavastha, Abhimani will change. Similarly, Tejasa will change, ever expanding. But still, never Purna. Across Janmas also, never Purna. But Sakshi is me, I am ever Purna. So that is the Jagratavastha Viveka. Swapna Avastha Viveka. How do you have Swapna Avastha Viveka? Yasyam Avasthayam Indriyanam Uparamat Tat Sahayam Antarena Eva Manaha Hitakya Nadyantaha Jagras Samskara Vashat Vishakarana Parinatam Sat Swayam Jyoti Swarupena Sakshina Anubhuyate Sa Avastha Swapna Avastha. So in this Avastha, what is it? Different from the earlier Avastha. So Yasyam Avasthayam Indriyanam Uparamat. The Indriyas resolve, and due to that, Tat Sahayam Antarena Eva Manaha Hitakya Nadyantaha Jagras Samskara Vashat Vishakarana Parinatam. So Parinatam Sat, who changes? Manaha. So the mind changes. Mind has a place now. The mind has a particular place in Swapna Avastha, which is said as in the Hita Nadi, called as Hita. The Nadi called as Hita, in that, in the 72,000 Nadis or whatever is mentioned in the Shastras, there is one Sukshma Nadi called as Hita. It is quite small. In fact, this is where some of the others, they take it literally, and they explain that Atma is there. Mana is there, Atma is there. There are so many differentiating explanations, but then all these are explanations. They are all Adhyarupasthaniya. There has to be Apavada there. Atma is not limited to the Hita Nadi Ityadi. But Jagrat Samskara is there. This mind enters the Hita Nadi, and then without the Indriyas, there is manifestation of the Mana in the form of Vishaya. And then Swayam Jyoti Swarupena Sakshina Anubhuyate. The Sakshi, me, Atma, I am Swayam Jyoti. But then Swayam Jyoti, Atma, I, Sakshi, by me, this Manaha is experienced. How? In the form of Swapna Prapancha. Sa Avastha, Swapna Avastha. That is Swapna Avastha. Atra Jivasya Sthanam Kantha. Where is the Jiva? Kantha. In Kantha, Shakti hi Jnanam. So Jnana is the Shakti, not Kriya. Vani is Madhyama, not Vaikari. Bhoga is Sukshma, not Stula. Guna is Raja, Rajaha Guna, not Sattva. Sanya is Taijasa, not Vishwa. Iti Swapna Avastha, Avasthasam, Avasthasu. Iti Swapna Avastha, Samagriha. Sorry. So I got a little confused here. Iti Swapna Avastha, Samagriha. So these are the six Samagris of Swapna Avastha. Jagras Sushupti Avasthayoho Iyam Swapna Avastha Na Bhavati. So Jagras Sushupti Avasthayoho Iyam Swapna Avastha Na Bhavati. So this is how you differentiate the Swapna Avastha from the other two. Atma tu Avasthatraya Sakshitvat Swapna Avasthataha Api Vilakshana Iti Swapna Avastha Vivekaha. So this is same as the earlier. How do you differentiate? Atma, I am Swapnavastha Vilakshana. Swapnavasthata Vilakshana. And then in continuation, also different from the Taijasa, who is Swapnavastha Abhimani. So from Mula, the tippana has done more, and during tippana we can see a little more, saying that swapna avasthata bhinna. So swapna avastha viveka, but I can also do taijasa viveka here itself, as I am not limited to taijasa also. Why? Avasthatre sakshitvat. Because I am a sakshi to the avastha, drishyatvat, drishya bhinna aham drik sakshi, natu kadapi drishyate. And also what? Bhinnatvam. Bhinnatvam is due to sakshitvat bhinnatvam. Avastha sakshitvat, avastha bhinnatvam. And also mithyatvam. This sakshi is real, but the others are drishyatvat mithya. We look at the Sushupti Avastha Viveka in the next part. Sukhan Nityam Saprakasham Vyapakan Namurupi Adhishthanam Buddhya Bodhyam Buddhir Drukyattu Nirvalam Aparam Sar Vedanta Vedyam Pratyak Paramaha Tadeva Annamattvanyat Iti Minishchitamati. Namaste, I'll see you in the next part.
Adhiyam.